morning. I'm only standing here. Because God is good. I'll tell your neighbor, he's so good. And this is why we can't forget the fact that you're in here trying to build the kingdom of God. You don't have a kingdom. You don't have a heaven. Matter of fact, you don't even have a hell. You just need to make sure you're not going that way. That's why when you get in here, you've got to recognize something. You didn't deserve to be saved. You didn't deserve to be in your right mind. You didn't deserve nothing that you stand up and say is yours. But what I bless God about is God has that unique ability that looks beyond all the mess that I did, all the stuff I was caught up in, the fact that my life was so jacked up, and still said, underneath all of the mess, I still have an anointing that I want to use to bless the body of Christ. And that's why I gotta recognize that it's not about me being exalted. It's not about anybody knowing my name. Because the truth of the matter is, if God didn't move on me on a Sunday morning, I ain't got nothing to tell none of y'all. But because of God, I'll tell somebody, it's got to be God. This is why when I look at it, I've got to recognize that every chance I get, everything's got to be about giving God some glory. Because when folk look at me, they don't get a deliverance. They don't get a healing. But when they come in contact with the God in me, their life begins to change. And this is why when the church starts to begin to look at itself, we've got to ask questions like, what is our purpose? Why do we gather here every Sunday morning? What is it that we're supposed to be doing between 11 and 2? And then after the benediction, because some of y'all won't agree with me, but when the world looks at us now, I believe the world sees a second great group of people, a people that have no vision, a people that have no direction. I'll tell somebody that is the truth. I know you didn't want to hear that. But see, it gets a little bit worse than that. Because we don't want to hear what God is saying. What many of us have allowed the church to do is morph into something that Jesus did not really call us to be. On the outside, it would be easy for the world to think that this is just an organization that is good for having fundraisers, that is good for having bake sales, fish fries, and selling hot dogs. But that ain't what Jesus called us to do. I know we gotta do it because some of you don't trust God to give you tithes. But when you go to Matthew chapter 16, and I'm starting to feel like preaching, what are you gonna get with me or not? Jesus looks at Peter, and Jesus said, thou art Peter. I'm gonna build my church. And he said, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. He went to the next verse and he said, and I give unto you the keys of the kingdom of heaven. And whatever you bind here on earth, I'm gonna bind it in heaven. And whatever you loose here on earth, I'm gonna loose in heaven. And it's when you look at those verses, what you see is Jesus is not concerned about the here and now, but he's establishing a kingdom that has eternal as its characteristics. So now the church has to ask, why are we coming here every Sunday? One, there's got to be worship. And when I'm talking about worship, I'm not talking about six folks standing up here with a microphone going through a list of songs. But worship is the key to a relationship with God. Worship unlocks the door that allows me to get in God's presence. Because when I come to God, I don't have to be asking nothing. But all I want to do is just get where he is and say, Father, I love you so much. Father, you're just an awesome God. And when I look at you, I see So now, now, now.